1/2 n equal to 1 to infinity alpha minus n alpha n plus 1/2 of mu equal to 0 to d minus 1 eta mu mu times this . So, I could write it this one as now we do the alpha minus n. So, what you do is you use those commutation relations that we derived, okay? And using those commutation relations and also using the fact that this is a scalar product in the d-dimensional space, okay? This is a product of two of them in the d-dimensional scalar. D dimensions. So then this is eta mu mu and mu equal to 0 to t minus 1, and this should be equals to d, and this we will take as equal to minus 1 by 12. Okay. So we can put these things back, and this would be 1/2 alpha 0 square plus 1/2 plus 1/2 of n equal to 1 to infinity of alpha minus n alpha n plus we would have d 1/2 d by 2 1/2 into d into minus 1 by 12. I sent you these links of this expression, and I was myself also pleasantly surprised to see that some of these guys they worried about this summation almost 190 years ago. So this is in the literature, it's called Ramanujan summation of natural numbers. And this was a very brilliant mathematician, came from very extremely poor family, worked as a clerk or something somewhere, and he was using the best papers in the postal department or wherever he was working on some port in South India, and he was somehow very brilliant. And this guy Thomas Hardy from England, he somehow noticed him and he took him away with him. He had no qualifications of any kind, but then he produced many brilliant results, and apparently he made the mistake of not taking good food. So he died with tuberculosis at a very young age of 32 or 37. So I have read I once gave a centenary celebration talk for his birth centenary celebrations some years ago. And then I happened to read more on him, that this guy was eating just rice, putting on it some salt and lemon all the time. And again, because he was so much busy all the time, he was working out. Even when he was on the deathbed, he was working out some numbers. So he's famous for number theory. Anyway, so we have this wonderful result with us, and we will see that this plays a very crucial role in fixing up the so-called the source of origin of the extra dimensions in string theory. Why you have capital D equal to 26. It is so crucial, this particular result. Let's now go a little bit further. And the results, let me still leave here. And this we can take. So this 1/2 plus 1/2 is 1. and this we can now use. So